Hello, Christ Cathedral Academy. It's Coach Garvey. At our virtual sports banquet for 2020. Yes, these are unprecedented times and scary times. But remember, God is with us, and that our faith will get us through them. Hopefully, tonight's video sports banquet will bring a little bit of light into your darkness. Now, before we begin, as we do with all things, let us begin in prayer. I've asked Miss Cameron to lead us in prayer.
Hello to all of our Christ Cathedral Academy families and athletic scholars. We would like to start today's banquet in prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Dear Lord, thank you for the opportunity to gather together as the Christ Cathedral Academy community does with so much joy in your name. We are assembled here today to celebrate the participation and successes of the student athletes and coaches of Christ Cathedral Academy. We have strived to learn from the coaches, compete as teams, and have learned to appreciate one another, whether in victory or defeat. Lord, you have looked down upon us with favor and spread the blessings of your love over these athletes through the joy of participation in athletics. May we all strive to live strong in our faith. All of this we pray in your name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Now, we have a lot to celebrate tonight. So, right now, let's take a look back in our great sports year at Christ Cathedral Academy. This includes multiple banners and championship runs and individual accomplishments as well. So athletes, families, Christ Cathedral Academy family, enjoy your viewing tonight.
So sorry I can't be with you today. However, I couldn't completely miss the chance to take a moment to share some thoughts with all of you. The lesson I cherish the most is how important it is to love what you do. If you love what you do and it's making you happy, all the hard work and perseverance will pay off. I once had a guidance counselor tell me that I shouldn't play basketball, that it would never amount to anything for me. His negativity towards me made me stronger. You can't stop people from trying to limit your dreams, but you can stop it from becoming a reality. Your dreams are up to you. I encourage you to always be curious, always seek out things you love, and always work hard once you find it. So with that, I'll let you carry on with your evening. Please know I'm thinking of you, supporting you, and encouraging you always. Peace.
said, don't give up, it's a little complicated, all tied up, no more love, and I'd hate to see you waiting. Had to have high hopes for living, shooting for the stars but I couldn't make a killing, didn't have a time but I always had a vision, always had high hopes. Had to have high hopes for living, didn't know how but I always had a feeling, I was gonna be that one in a million, always had high hopes. Mama said, said, don't give up, it's a little complicated, all tied up, no more love, and I'd hate to see you waiting. They say it's all been done, but they haven't seen the best of me, so I got one more run, and it's gonna be a sight to see, had to have high, high hopes for a living, shooting for the stars when I couldn't make a killing, didn't have a dime. Always had high, high hopes. Had to have high, high hopes for a living. Didn't know how, but I always had a feeling I was gonna be that one in a million. Always had high, high hopes. Had to have high, high hopes for a living. Shooting for the stars, but I couldn't make a killing. Didn't have a time, but I always had a vision. Always had high, high hopes. Had to have
summer where I played basketball when I was like 10 or 11 years old, and I scored not a free throw, not a nothing, not a lucky shot, not a breakaway layup, 0 points. And I remember crying about it and being upset about it, and my father just gave me a hug and said, listen, whether you score zero or score 60, I'm gonna love you no matter what. But to hell with that, I'm scoring 60.
Twisting my head, but I'm still dreadful, and I got plenty of bread, so I go to plan, please. This year ain't cynical. Nano subliminal, I'm physical, financial, and mental to be a general. Hey, the mama claims she want a soldier. Not the type be in the tank, but in that rover. Man, please, I'm in the zone like AIDS full blown. I'm killing it like a blind man reading. I'm feeling it like, oh, yeah. Here comes the, oh, here comes the, oh, here comes the dollar. He ain't never been a fighter. You can go and ask his mother. I'm a lover and a fighter.
A fighter,
producer and a writer.
A writer.
Give your girl a quick fix and give your man a nice shiner. You know y'all don't really want it. And I can tell just by looking at you that you the type to run and go and tell just by looking at you. You on a mission for recognition by dissing. Didn't have no problem till the record started breaking. But y'all don't really want it. So let me tell you the deal. I'm also serious. I'm dirty. I'm no longer for real. I'm like a hop, skipping the jump, a clock grip on the pump, from leaving you in the trunk, somewhere prepared to jump. But y'all don't really want it, so quit acting like you're deaf. I'm looking to my ride, trying to see who's left. So hard, you better watch it before I stick to the plan and be the next artist to run up in your stand. Like, ooh, yeah, here comes the, ooh, here comes the, ooh, here comes the, y'all don't really want it. Like, ooh, yeah, here comes the, ooh, here comes the, ooh, here comes the.
Concerned with status, but still leaving them starstruck. Humble through opportunities given despite the fact that many misjudge him because he makes a living from writing raps. Put it together himself, got a picture connects. Never asking for someone's help, but to get some respect. He's only focused on what he wrote. His will is beyond reach, and now it all unfolds, the skill of an artist.
This is 20% skill, 80% fear. Be 100% clear, because Ryu was ill. Who would have thought he'd be the one that set the West in flames? And I heard him wreck it with the crystal method, name of the game. Came back, dropped Megadeth, took him to church. I like Bleach, man. Why you had the stupidest verses? Dude, it's the truth. Now everybody giving them guest spots and stocks through the roof. I heard him with that style.
This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5%
spitting fire in Mike. Got him out the dryer, he's hot. Found him in Fort Minor with top, but a nihilist porcupine. He's a the type women wanna be within. Rappers hope he gets 8 years in the making, patiently waiting to blow. Now the record with Shinoda's taking over the globe. He's got a partner in crime, his is equally dope. You won't believe the kind of that comes out of this kid's throat top.
He's not your everyday on the block. He knows how to work with what he's got, making his way to the top. He often gets a comment on his name. People keep asking him, was it giving that birth or does it stand for an acronym? No, he's living proof. Let him rock in the booth. He'll get you buzzing quicker than a shot of vodka with juice. Him and his crew are known around as one of the best. Dedicated to what they do and give 100%.
Forget Mike. Nobody really knows how or why he works so hard. It seems like he's never got time, because he writes every note and he writes every line. And I've seen him at work when that light goes on in his mind. It's like a design is written in his head every time, before he even touches a key or speaks in a rhyme. And those other fellas he runs with, the kids that he signed, ridiculous, without even trying. How do they do it? This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name. This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name.
Yeah. Fort Minor, M. Shinoda, Styles of Beyond, Ryu, Talk.
When you step out on that field, everyone's equal. Talent, it means nothing. They may be more talented than you, but if you show more heart, if you show more focus, if you just decide this day that you will never accept second place to anyone, if you do that, if you all do that, there's no one we cannot defeat. And there's no one that will want to challenge us ever again. So do you want to go out there like every other player, like every other team? Or do you want to stand up this day to make this day count?
Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe.
Wish I didn't think I had the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that glass first. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would've gotten out of my show. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about what other people thought and felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you, and that futon. We just begun. On the grass dreaming, figuring out who I was. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Never thought we'd get old. Maybe we're still young. Maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past. While I'm missing out on that, we've come so far. I guess I'm fine. And I ain't worried about the way that we're missing. I got some scars. I've been around. I've had some pain, I've seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know what you got till
we're first going to begin with our volleyball teams. So for girls B2, Coach T. Also want to recognize the Sejas and Mrs. Stritsopoulos, who helped out from time to time in practice. Really do appreciate everything that you did for our volleyball program. So without further ado, we will hear from Coach T about her awards and season. Thank you.
Hi girls, this is Coach T. As you can see, I have my shirt on. I wanted to congratulate all the winners and all the girls as well. I wish I can give everyone an award, but we're only allowed to give out three. But I just want to say I'm so proud of you all. Continue to work hard. I've seen a lot of growth in you this past season, and I'm so proud. I'm very proud, and continue to work hard, because I'm a firm believer of hard work, and it will all pay off. So I can't wait for all this to be over so I can see you guys again in the gym. And also thank you so much to my assistants, Coach Oscar, Coach Ali, and Coach Monique. Thank you so much. I couldn't have done it without you guys. So I love you girls. I miss you all, and can't wait to see you. Stay healthy. Love you all. Bye.
All right. And without further ado, your winners for the Girls B2 Volleyball Awards are: for Most Improved, Izzy Dritsopoulos. Next up, your Coach's Award is Melissa Seha. And your Most Valuable Player, Francis Doe. Congratulations, everyone.
Now, our Girls B1 team had a great season. They went 7-3. They came very close to beating St. Irenaeus, who was, we all know, was a great, great volleyball team. So the girls, I saw them improve a lot from the beginning of the season. But there's one player that stood out, and they're going to get our Most Improved Player of the Year award. For Girls B1, Kaylee Zavala. Now, I remember early on she struggled, she was new to the game, but she practiced hard, not only after school, but on the weekends, and really improved her game and contributed a lot throughout our season. So Kaylee, congratulations, keep up the good work. Next up, our Coach's Award. Now, the Coach's Award is for different reasons. Could be you are supporting your teammates, you are an awesome contributor to the team, great leadership. This athlete had all three of those characteristics. So for your Coach's Award, the loudest one on the court, Angie Soria. And last but not least, your Most Valuable Player. Now, it's easy to see how talented this young player is. The minute you see her serve, you know that she is the most valuable player for that team. So Melina Gonzalez, you are our Girls B1 2020 Most Valuable Player. Thank you, ladies, and keep practicing, and hopefully we'll see some of you, actually all of you, next year on the Girls A team. Now, I was also the coach of the Girls A volleyball team. So to mix it up, we're gonna travel to a whole new destination. I'll see you there. Don't worry, I'll still be wearing my suit. Oh, here I am. I like this spot. Get used to this. So let's talk about our girls A team. These girls, they learned a lot as to what it means to be a team, how to support one another, and how to work hard in practice. These girls didn't always want to work, but when they were challenged to do so, they rose to the occasion. They had a great season. They played teams hard, the long sets. And really, the thing that I was most proud of throughout the year was the resilience of the team. They never wanted to give up, and they loved just playing the game. They really reminded me of that this is a fun game and that we should be enjoying ourselves out there. So thank you, girls, to remind me of that. Sometimes I forget. I want to push you and push you so that you can be your greatest, but at the end of the day, it's about having fun. So thank you, ladies. So without further ado, our Girls A Volleyball Team Awards. Most improved. This athlete, for years I tried to convince her to play volleyball. Finally, her eighth grade year, she joined. Well, by the end of the season, this player was one of our starting setters. So Brianna Nguyen, congratulations. Next up, we have our coaches award. Now, this award goes to a player who always tried to lead on the court through her example, through her words, and never gave up. She's a great example to her teammates, and will truly be missed next year. So Naomi Castro, 2020 Girls A Coaches Award goes to you. Next up, your most valuable player. So this next player, I want to say, has improved her skills drastically since joining volleyball here at Christ Cathedral Academy. She works hard, has a great serve, and great passer, great hitter, just great all-around player. Also, a leader on the team, vocally and through her actions. So your most valuable player, Kim Nguyen. Thank you, ladies, for you eighth graders. I hope you continue on and play for your high school next year. Work hard in the off season this summer and continue to play. You seventh graders, hope you keep at it and join again next year. Now we have Boys B2 coach, Coach Jay.
Hey everyone, this is Coach Jay, and I am sharing this video to announce the B2 Boys Basketball Team Award winners. But before that, I would like to start with thanking all the parents and family members and all the others who supported the B2 Boys throughout their season. It was a rough start for the boys against bigger and older competition, but with that, they gained this experience and they actually showed a lot of improvement that they should be able to take moving forward. And with that, let's start with the awards. First off is the Most Improved Player Award, which is given to the student athlete who displayed the most improvement and growth in improving their game and contributing to the success of the team. This award goes to Mateo Ramirez. Congratulations. Next would be the Coaches Award. This award is given to the student athlete who displayed the commitment and passion, as well as provided or gave his 100% effort each and every time. And the winner of this award is Jairo Orejel. Congratulations. And last but not the least, the most hard-earned and most coveted award of them all, the Most Valuable Player Award. This award pertains to the student athlete that whose contributions actually determined the success of the team, and win or lose to that, as well as inspired others to do better and play better, to be competitive and come out winners despite whatever the score is on the scoreboard at the end of the game. The recipient of the MVP award is Sebastian Yu. Once again, to all the award winners, congratulations, and always stay safe. Have a good one. Bye.
First year coach, thank you so much, Coach J, for your service. Truly did guide these boys to a great year. Next up, we have Coach Mike.
Hello, everyone. This is Coach Mike in Hibernation. I'm the coach of the B1 boys team. This year, I was privileged enough to coach a championship team. I just want to take a little bit of time to acknowledge all my players. They consisted of Matthew, Nathan, Nguyen, Santi, Dayton, Andrew, Emilio, Nick, Brian, Tim, and Vincent. A championship team that went 10-0 in league play, 13-1 overall. A fantastic season, boys. Congratulations. I was asked to give out 3 awards today, but really, 11 awards should be given out because you're all champions in my book. The 3 awards are Most Improved, Coaches Award, and MVP. This year's Most Improved Player goes to Emilio. Emilio, when you were locked in and focused, there's nothing you couldn't do. You had a wonderful season. Thank you for making this team a great team. The Coach's Award goes to Timothy Carrigal. You, without a doubt, was my go-to player. When I asked you to lock down the best player on the other team, you did it. When I asked you to shoot a timely 3, you gave it to me. When I asked you to be a leader on the team, you stepped up. Thank you. Thank you for all you do. A wonderful season. Congratulations, team. And finally, the MVP goes to Vincent. But I want to make sure that you guys all know, all 10 of you made Vincent the MVP this year. He was most consistent because you helped him. And that is the 3 awards. Congratulations again on a great season. I just want to thank you, all the parents. I want to say a special thanks to Coach Danny, who always came by to sit with me on the bench and to support the kids. We had a wonderful, wonderful season. I feel blessed to have been your coach, and I want you to finish out this year safe and sound with your family during this quarantine. Thank you, and God bless.
Next up, we'll hear from Coach Eric, our Boys A coach.
Hello, everyone. I'll be doing the Boys A video. Coach Eric, unfortunately, couldn't film a video, but he did let me know his winners, so I will let you know what those are later. The Boys A had a great season. I think, for me, one of the most memorable wins I've ever seen in our gym against St. Irenaeus. I mean, that was an epic win. The boys showed a lot of heart in that game. And the other thing that I wanted to say about the Boys A team is that they supported one another wholeheartedly. Everybody on the bench, anytime anybody on the team would get in, make a bucket, they were standing up, cheering, supporting their teammates. So good job, Boys A, on a great season. And for you eighth graders, best of luck to you in high school. Hopefully, you know, you seventh graders, you keep working hard. Come back next year even stronger, okay? And now for your winners. For your most improved, DJ Vu. And for your coach's award, it's going to Saeed Magayon. And your most valuable player for Boys A for 2020 is Julian Jimenez.
We're now going to hear from our girls B2 coach, Coach Melissa.
Hi everybody, this is Melissa. I had the honor of coaching the girls basketball B2 team this year. And I wanted to come on here and just kind of give a little bit of a recap of our great season. Although we didn't win every single game, I think we did an amazing job as a team, especially for the girls that came onto the team with this being their first year playing. I think that we did an amazing job. For the girls that returned, it was great to have them again and see the growth from last season to this season. I know we're not having an official banquet or anything, so that's kind of why I'm on here telling you a little bit about the season and the girls. With that being said, I do have my three girls that I chose for our honor them with the awards. The three categories were most valuable player, a coach's award, and most improved. With that being said, I wanted to start with the most improved award. I wanted to choose this young lady because she came in very first practice, very first game, very timid, very shy, and just a sweet girl, a petite girl, so very, you know, she kind of was backing up from everybody and not trying to get in there as much as others. So I definitely saw that in her at the very beginning with practice. She was always there during practice and kind of, you know, giving it her all and trying during practice. The very last game, she had an amazing game. She was just putting so much effort going up against much bigger girls and kind of just putting her body out there, just like I was telling her. And I think she just deserves it because I saw the amount of growth from the very first game or the very first practice to the very last game. I cannot wait to see what she has planned for us for next season, and I really hope to see her next season. With that being said, this award, I wanted to kind of honor it for Madison. I wanted to congratulate her on amazing work that she put in, and just, you know, her passion comes to show. She was always there, was on time, and always giving it some hard work. So thank you, Madison, for all your hard work, and I can't wait to see you next season. Next award, I wanted to go with the coach's award, which kind of I based it on just somebody who is a leader, somebody who kind of has their head high and is somebody that you is very reliable, somebody that you can tell something to, and is not, it's not somebody that's gonna give you any attitude back, or, you know, just not any smart talk or anything like that, which none of the girls did. But just, you know, she kind of stood out to me because I would tell her something and I would never have to tell her again. It was like I would yell at her or kind of tell her something that I felt she needed to work on or she could try and do, and that was it. She went in there and did that exact same thing, which to me shows a lot about a person and character. Every single game, every single practice, she worked hard, and she did what she was told, and she's just a good listener and a good player, and she has a lot of heart. So I can't wait to see the growth on her and what she's gonna achieve, which I hope that she comes back and plays another season for us, because she's gonna do great things. With that being said, that award, I wanted to honor, oh my God, I'm gonna butcher her name. Kaylee, yes. I wanted to congratulate her and tell her thank you for such amazing hard work that she did for everybody, for the girls, for the team, and for herself. She's a really strong young lady, with that height and that attitude and all that heart that she plays with. She's gonna go very far. So congratulations, and I can't wait to see you next season. Last but not least, we have our most valuable player. This was, you know, an award where I kind of thought of, you know, who stands out, who does hard work, who does, you know, all the things. I chose Diana because she came to me from last season, and just like last season, she puts in work, a lot of work. She loves the game, and it shows on the court. There was never a moment where I could even take her out because she wouldn't allow me to. I would take her out and she was like, what did I do wrong? What can I fix? What, you know, it was always a growing point for her. She, you know, she knew what she was doing with the ball. She kind of took control and she helped her teammates grow. Which is really a leader in my opinion. It's somebody that is somebody that's going to take care of everybody else, taking care of her team. You had an amazing season, Diana. You did great every single game that you played. You played it with a lot of heart. Thank you so much for letting me coach you one more time, because I'm sure next year I won't have that honor. It was really good to have you again one more time. I can't wait to see what is in store for you all these years, and I just hope that you keep playing with that passion and that heart, and even if it gets you fouled out, you're playing with heart, and that's all that matters, really. Well, thank you all. All of my girls did amazing. It was a great season for everyone. I feel like everybody took something from this, and I can't wait for us to see each other again, and hopefully everybody that played this season will come back and play next and improve and do all great things. Well, that was my three girls. Thank you guys for everything. I appreciate it, and I can't wait to see you soon. Take care.
Next up, we have our girls B1 coach, Mr. Seha.
Thank you, Mr. Irving. My name is Oscar Seha. Me and my wife have been coaching the girls B1 since 2015-2016, and it has been an amazing experience. This year, our girls B1 ended up in second place in the San Barbara tournament. We lost by 1 point. Very close, very close. In the league, we were undefeated, 10-0. The girls did an amazing job. Very proud of them. Our girls B1 team is very diverse. We have 2 fourth graders, 3 fifth graders, and 2 sixth graders. Our fourth graders, Coco and Carly. Coco, you did an amazing job. You have skills. I know you're gonna do good things next year. We look forward to see that. Carly, same thing. You did an amazing job. You had the speed, you had the skills. We look forward to see what you're gonna do next year. I know you both were gonna do very well. our fifth graders, we have Izzy. Izzy very eager to play, always wanted to be in the game. Mrs. Zach, can I go in? Can I go in? Thank you so much. Keep learning, keep working. You'll do great things next year, I know you will. Bella, you have improved so much. Keep working hard, keep working hard. You know, you have come up a long way. We're very proud of you. Melissa Ceja, you're okay, you're good. Keep doing the good job. You have come up a long way too. Keep working hard. I don't know who you are, but keep working. Our sixth graders, Vivian, you know, you played last year and I happened to coach you last year and I saw that you have a lot of potential since last year. Keep working hard. I know you have a lot of potential and you will do great things. You do great things, I know you will. And Eva, you know, Eva, you have come out a long way. This is my first year coaching you this year, but you have learned a lot of things this year and I'm very, very proud of you. This year, just like any other year, we have to choose our top three. And it's always the very hard decision to do. But this year, for the most improved, you know, this girl, like I said, she has come up a long way. Her skills has, you know, have improved so much, and she has improved not only her skills, but her communication on the court, talking to the players, talking to making sure they know what they're doing, and pulling everybody together. The most improved award goes to Bella. Coach's award. This award is gonna go to a girl that it's very amazing. She does a lot of things. She can dribble, she can shoot. She can play defense. And when she plays defense, she doesn't care whether it's a little one or a tall one. You know, she's always a team player. She's working with everybody. And she's amazing. I'm looking to see what she's gonna do next year. Coach's award goes to Melissa Ceja. Our MVP for this year, for the B1, this girl, same thing, she was all over the court. She can play defense, she can dribble, she can be the point guard, she can shoot. She's all well-rounded. Our MVP for this year is Emma. Thanks, everyone. Thank you, parents. Thank you, students. Thank you for allowing me to coach. Thank you, parents, for allowing me to coach your girl. Sorry for all the screaming, but we look forward to have them, all of them, next year. Thank you again, and we look forward to see you.
Next up, I want to give a big round of applause to Coach Ceja for the Girls A. What a great run your team had this year. And I'm looking forward to seeing a lot of you playing in high school and on next year's team for CCA.
Thank you, Mr. Gavi. Hi, my name is Alejandra Ceja and I start coaching the Girls B in 2015-2016. Ever since I started coaching, it has been a great journey, and with all my mijas, that means all my daughters, if you guys don't know. This team went from not knowing how to dribble the ball to earn more than 7 trophies, 3 banners, and just recently, a very proud second place in the playoffs. Whoa, that's amazing. We as coaches could not be more proud of them. This team has exceeded in our expectations. This team has made history and it has raised the bar of the future of CCA girls team. This year, like in the past, we select 3 girls to be awarded. Every year it gets the most difficult decision we have to make. Every year it gets hotter and hotter, especially when you know everyone is on your team, has so much talent and potential. Like, for instance, take a look at the 7 graders. Like, Rachel is a young lady with a great positive attitude and always ready to learn. Every year, she gets better and better. Ceci is a caring young lady and always trying to do right and making it fair for everyone. Sophia, she's always trying to improve, follows instructions, and always ready to learn. She has improved a lot. Genevieve, Genevieve is a young lady with so much energy and is always willing to go on and beyond. Naomi, what can I say about Naomi? Naomi is very committed, very respectful, and she's a hard worker. And she has a lot of team spirit. That's Naomi. Kim Torres, what can I say about Kim Torres? Is a very good defender. She's ready to attack and steal the ball. She's a great and rebounding. Very proud of her. Thank you, Kim Torres. Isabel Lau has amazing speed. Her speed has helped us a lot, and she plays really good defense as well. Kim Nguyen is a young lady that plays very good as a low post, and she has a lot of spirit and a great leadership. Brianna is a great point guard. She has growth and has learned so much. She understands the importance of being a team. By far, you all deserve to be recognized, but I can only choose three. Most improved. This young lady always has second thoughts on starting the game. Over the years, she improved her shooting, her defense, communication spirit, and her leadership. She plays a very good defense and it has a lot of potential. Most improved awards goes to Kim Nguyen. Coach's award. This young lady has a lot of potential. She is very eager to play. She can play many positions. She's always ready to play. Her passion is to the game, inspire other people. Coach's award goes to Genevieve. Very good job, Genevieve. MVP award. This young lady has come a long way. She has learned the importance of playing as a team. She is a great leader and has learned to help the team to score. She gave the most of the assists this year, and by far, she is the one that got the most nervous. This year, MVP is Brianna Nguyen. Thank you, parents, for trusting us.
Thank you, players, for allowing us to coach such an amazing team.
We are very proud of every single of you.
And we cannot wait to see what each one of you accomplished next year. Thank you.
And we miss you.
Now this is a message for our student athletes. I know this is a scary and unusual time, but remember, your health and safety is what is most important. One thing that you can do to keep healthy is to be staying physically active. So during these times, if you have a volleyball, basketball, whatever it may be at home, soccer ball even, get out and stay active. Shoot some hoops, pass the ball against the wall, whatever it may be. Stay active, stay healthy, stay strong.